Welcome to the CEO TV show with Robert Reese. Today, Rafael Pastor, Chairman and CEO of Vistage International, looks at the CEO's role in the future of America.
Rafael, how do you think CEOs view the state America is in today?
We run this Vistage CEO Confidence Index every quarter, have done that now for more than 7 years. And it's become probably the best barometer of what small, medium-sized business CEOs think about the economy, both going backward and going into the future. And resoundingly, the level of confidence in the economy and in their own businesses is way up. It's up to a degree that it hasn't been the last couple of years. And that's in terms of their own businesses' revenues, their own businesses' profits, their own businesses' hiring. Going forward, next 12 months, their level of confidence is way up. Their confidence in the overall economy is way up. That's all bodes very well for the future.
So when you're talking about this growth, is this America or are they more optimistic overseas, areas like China?
Interesting you should ask that, Robert, because we specifically asked them a question, this last Vistage CEO Confidence Index, never asked them that before. Which economy do you think will be the most improved in 3 years? And we listed US, China, India, South America, Europe, and some others perhaps. Resoundingly, they said America. United States, 49%.
Did they say why?
The question wasn't asked why, but I can surmise, I think somewhat intelligently, why I think that is. I think that CEOs in America still actually believe in the American dream and in their capacity to influence it. I think that for two reasons. First of all, because I believe it. I'm an immigrant to this country. I came here when I was 9 years old. And I think this country is all that all of our ancestors ever wanted it to be. It has been for me, it has been, and I'm very grateful to my parents for bringing it here. It is still a land of opportunity, it is still a land of innovation. That's why so many people from around the world still want to come to study here and live here and make their careers here. Unfortunately, our immigration policies makes it way too hard for them. This is still a country of great, great opportunity. I believe that. Secondly, our CEOs themselves, as long as they are allowed to kind of do things by their own devices, with the least amount of taxation and government intrusion, as long as they can innovate, be entrepreneurs, take risks, look around the what's around the corner, they have confidence in themselves. And I think what this is telling us, when they say 3 years from now we're going to be the most improved economy, I think what they're telling us is, despite all the impasse in Washington, despite all the risks coming out of Europe, despite all the uncertainty, which they're also concerned about, fundamentally, we, the CEOs who run these businesses and can really impact the economy, we're going to do things that the rest of the world cannot in terms of innovation, growth, and hiring. That underbelly of confidence sort of is indestructible, despite all the forces and all the politicians who might get in its way.
So you really see it's about the American dream and innovation that are the future.
As long as you let people do what we've always done, which is innovate, take risks, and just be one step ahead of everybody else.
And if small business continues to be a huge engine of innovation and of growth, and as you said, represents 50% of the GDP, 75% of the workforce, what do you see the future over the next 10 years as being?
I think the future for the American economy, irrespective of who's in the White House or who's running Congress, is very, very bright. I believe that viscerally. I see that from our confidence index, and I see it from the people themselves who are the members of Vistage, all these CEOs. They're real-life human beings. I know them. And I would put my money in them ahead of putting my money in any other counterpart of theirs, whether it's in China, Europe, or anywhere else in the world.